For our next segment, we turn it over to Boyet Season for the third installment of the history of celebrity boxing.
Hello mga ka-rounder! Kumusta na po kayo? Okay, meron pa pala akong pahabol na kwento tungkol kay Muhammad Ali at kay Wilt Chamberlain. Alam nyo ba, noong 1971, lumaban itong si Wilt Chamberlain sa isang pamosong singer. Teka. Ganito yan. Meron isang tanyag na show sa Amerika na nung mga panahon na yon ay napapanood din dito sa Pilipinas. Ang titulo po nito ay ang Rowan and Martin's Laugh-In na pinagbibinahan ng mga sikat na komedyante na sina Dan Rowan at Dick Martin. Isipin nyo lang parang ganito, Dolphy and Panchito sa programang Buhay Artista. Ah, di ba? Ganun ang peg. Kung buhay na kayo nun. Siyempre, para sa inyo mga millennials, tanungin yung mga lolo nyo, mga tita nyo, mga tito-tita nyo. Okay? Sige. Okay. Ngayon, itong programa nito, mga kaibigan, ay merong sketch noong 1971 dubbed as, or may titulo na, The Fight of the Century. Where the... yung maglalaban eh dalawa sa pinakatanyag na tao sa mundo nung panahon na yon. One of them was American singer, dancer, actor, vaudevillian, and comedian Sammy Davis Jr. Yes, Mr. Bojangles himself, who plays the role of the boxer with the name Jolton Jr. Davis. At si NBA star naman, Wilt Chamberlain, played the role of a guy with the name of Tiny Irish Bob Murphy. Ngayon, sa skit na ito, si Davis ay agad nagre-reklamo and eventually takes issue with both the descriptors, namely Tiny and Irish. Alam niyo yung sabihin ng slang na Irish? May ibig sabihin yun eh. Hanapin nyo, Google nyo. Alam nyo, sabi ni Davis eh sa laki ba naman yan? Tiny Irish pa. Eh bakit? Ba't tiny Irish? Eh laki-laki niyan. Anyway, si Davis mga kaibigan ay may height na 5 feet 5 inches lamang. At ito ay mas naging katawa-tawa dahil he was up against Chamberlain who had a height of 7 feet 1 inch as far as height is concerned, weighed 275 pounds. At idagdag niyo pa na ang wingspan ni Chamberlain was a whopping 7 feet 8 inches. So, di ba? Tiny Irish nga daw. Now, the fight scene, which has been viewed for more than 24 million times since being uploaded to YouTube, is truly one of the most hilarious physical comedy routines of that time. Between 1968 and 1973, Davis was a frequent guest on Rowan and Martin's Laugh-In and often used his size to great effect on screen. Now, Chamberlain has also appeared several times on the show, but unlike Davis, Chamberlain only had a few acting credits to his lifetime. Two of those well-known being the Rowan and Martin Laugh-In sketch that I just mentioned to you and the 1984 film Conan the Destroyer, where he starred with Arnold Schwarzenegger. Wilt did not say, "I'll be back," as far as the movies were concerned. Okay, ito naman. Bago yung Floyd Mayweather versus Conor McGregor na kung saan isang boxer ay lumaban sa isang wrestler, alam nyo ba na lumaban si Muhammad Ali sa isang wrestler na si Antonio the Pelican Inoki? Interesting, isn't it? Now, the idea of fighting Japanese wrestler Antonio Inoki supposedly happened about 1975 in April when Ali was introduced to Ichiro Yada, the president of the Japanese Amateur Wrestling Association. Sa isang reception doon sa US, ang kwento daw ng mga naroon ay, mayabang na sinabi ni Ali kay Mr. Yada na, "Is there any Oriental fighter who will challenge me? I'll give you $1 million if he wins." Now, the staged, managed remark suddenly was headline news in Japan. Now, top rank boxing promoter Bob Arum, yes, you know him, you know Bob Arum, and wrestling impresario Vince McMahon Jr., senior, kilala nyo rin yan, put the deal together. Now, Inoki accepted the challenge and eventually Ali accepted the $6 million US dollar final offer from Inoki's backers. Now, in March 1976, the fight was made. The venue? Budokan Hall in Tokyo. The date? The 26th of June, the year 1976. Now, 8 months after winning this final fight against Joe Frazier, in the Thrill of Manila in October of 1975, Ali has been busy boxing lesser-known opponents. Kailangan kasi ni Ali, after the Frazier fight, na parati siyang nasa public eye, na parati siyang laman ng balita. So, sabi niya, at the age of 33, sabi niya, okay, at tinasiguro yung huling taon ko, tapos magre-retiro na ako. Now, usap, revision ng rules, palit na palit yung rules, mga kaibigan. Pero ito, yung mga rule changes nila affected Antonio Inoko more than Ali. Tapos na nakalagay doon, bawal sumipa, kicking is prohibited and would be declared a foul unless the person delivering the blow was kneeling, squatting, or operating down on the canvas. So nakailata. Now, takedowns were allowed, but since but nung panahon na yon, nung mahawak si Ali sa ropes, there had to be a break. So kailangan paghiwalayin sila. Leg holds were prohibited, leg sweeps, leg whips, and leg pulls were allowed only up to the shins, no? Hanggang sa shins lamang, sa ibabaw or the top side of the foot. The palm or heel strikes by Inoki were okay, but not below the belt, the Adam's apple, or the groin. Blows of many other parts of the body were prohibited, and neither fighter could use the knee or the elbow. Now, other than the first 14 seconds of the first round, when Inoki ran across the ring and tried to land a flying kick on Ali, the Pelican spent the rest of the match on his backside, kicking furiously at Ali as an attempt to corner him. Now, Ali spent most of the match taunting Inoki, challenging him to stand up and fight like a man. Alam nyo, the fight, such as it was scored a draw. Inoki had been 3 points up in the bout, but well, conveniently, he was adjudged fouls as well. 3 fouls. So, di ba? Parang na-wipe out lang yung lamang niya na three points. In theory, now the tie, it was ruled a draw. The theory was no one had lost face, walang napahiya, no? Especially as Inoki could claim that he had won it fair and square had it not been for the penalties, whereas Ali could defend himself by saying his opponent had cheated. Now, the two fighters, of course, could take consolation in the fact now that they were both several millions of dollars richer. Now, the Muhammad Ali versus Antonio Inoki fight certainly did not live up to the hype, but it opened people's eyes to the possibility of uniting fighting styles. No? Yung pag-unite ng mga estilo ng paglalaban, kasi may karate, may judo, di ba? May boxing. So, ngayon, sabi nila, uy, alam mo yung laban pala na yun could have really become the cursor or the start of what we now know as mixed martial arts. Ano sa palagay nyo, mga ka-rounder? Send us your comments and or suggestions to our Facebook page. That's Round by Round All Boxing. And keep on watching our Facebook page and our YouTube channel.